Hi everyone, I'm Miss Katie from Rockland Public Library, and today we're going to be reading another book off of the Chickadee nominee list. After this one, we just have three left before we vote on our very favorite. Today's story is called Negative Cat. Negative Cat is by Sophie Blackall. Let's see what happens in Negative Cat. Can you see this cat? It's staring at the wall. On day 427 of asking for a cat. Cat? Cat? Cat! Meow. Milk. Cat? My parents finally gave in. Please! Okay. You have to feed it and clean out the litter. It better not have fleas. Also keep your room tidy and write to your grandma and read for 20 minutes every day. Ugh, I'm not so great at reading. Words only make sense when I read them out loud slowly. And kids at school stare and laugh at me. But I agree to the rules before my parents change their mind. I'm getting a cat. I'm getting a cat. I'm getting a cat. There are a million cats in the rescue shelter. I want to take them all home, but Mom says, only one. Then I find him. The name on the cage is Pookie, but that is no name for this cat. This cat is Maximilian Augustus Xavier, and we will call him Max. What a mighty name. Max could be short for Maximilian, but also the initials of the kitty, Maximilian M, Augustus A, Xavier X, spells M-A-X, Max. When we get home, I'm excited to show Max his bed and his scratching post and his litter tray and his scent of the sea frisky bits. He is not excited. The next day, I surprise Max with a new toy mouse. He is not surprised. I tickle him with a feather. He is not ticklish. I tell him my all-time best joke. He doesn't even smile. At school, my friends go on about how excellent their cats are. Camilla can wear her cat like a scarf. Jack's cat can fetch a stick. Emilio's cat has its own Instagram. My cat stares at the wall. It's a negative, your cat. On the weekend, Dad lets Max have the best part of the paper. Can you see the cat holding on? Oh, it's not gonna give it up. Uncle Dave knits him a sweater. Mom lets him borrow her shoes. In return, Max leaves hairballs on the rug, his tail in the butter, and poop in the vestibule. He eats the flowers and deletes my email to my grandma. Oh. Vestibule is like the area where you might put your boots when you come into the house. It's like the hallway or the beginning of your house. Everyone is mad at Max. He doesn't even purr. I'm calling the shelter. We should have got a dog. And then they're mad at me. Your room is a mess. He hasn't been doing his reading. Have you even written to your grandma? I still love you, Max. When the lady from the shelter comes, Max and I hide in my room. The grown-ups talk on and on. Blah, 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 commitment. Blah, 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 responsibility. Blah, 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 negative. I have an idea. It's our only hope. I tidy my room in record time. I reach for a book. I take a deep breath. And I begin to read slowly, out loud, the only way I know how. Max stares, but
He doesn't laugh.
I turn the page. Max inches closer and closer and closer. He tucks his head under my arm. I stay perfectly still and I read and read right to the very end of the book. The lady from the shelter says Max and I should come and read to all the cats to cheer them up. So we do. Now my whole class comes every Tuesday and we all read out loud, fast or slow, however we like. The cats are happy, the lady at the shelter is happy, and the parents are happy.
Look at everyone reading to their cat. This one's even showing the cat the pictures. Oh, look where this cat is.
All the parents are happy. Well, sort of. Can we please get a cat? Can we get a cat, please? Can we please get a cat? Can we get a cat? Can we get a cat?
Oh, can we please get a cat?
Can we get a cat?
Oh, no. The end. Great listening, everyone. So that is something that animals love, and animals can be so comforting to read to. There are some animals, like we have had a dog come into the library quite a few times to read to, but dogs and cats and other animals can be a great audience. They read, they listen to you, and they don't judge. And the author left a little note at the end. When my kids were little, we adopted a cat from the animal shelter. The sign on the cage said her name was Cinnamon, but we called her Claudia, after the character from the mixed-up files of Mrs. Basil E. Frankweiler. And also Claudia, because she had claws. Over the years, she grew into what my son described as a negative cat. She ate flowers, hogged the newspaper, and stared at the wall. She would ask to be stroked, then bite your hand. She would demand to be fed, throw up on the carpet, and then complain she was hungry. But we loved her. You see her right there? With her hat, head in the cup. Our own Claudia was a negative cat for most of her life, but she became surprisingly sweet in her final days. If only we'd read to her sooner. So maybe you can find an animal you have at home, or maybe a stuffed animal you have at home, and try reading to them today. It might be a great audience. I hope you enjoyed this book, and I can't wait to read to you all soon. Have a great week. Bye-bye.